more examples. They are somewhat different from the previous module. Now I am taking the one more number, 3227, and divide it by 9. First step, yes, you know very well. Write first digit as it is. Now add next digit to this 3, you will get 5. Now next, add this 5 to the next digit, you will get 7. Now you will put stock here. Now add 7 and 7, you will get 14. Okay, now 14 is your remainder. Is it possible? The remainder can be more than the divisor. Here you know, when you divide any number, this we call divisor. It is dividend, and here you get quotient, and this is the remainder. And even you know very well, remainder is always less than the divisor. Let's take one example. If I am going to divide 16 by 3, 3, 5, 15, you will get 1 remainder. And if you divide 16 by 3, some students generally do. Now remainder is 4. Which one is correct? Yes, this is correct. Because remainder is 4. And remainder is greater than the divisor, it is not possible. Remainder is always less than the divisor or equal to 0, means when it is completely divisible, then remainder is 0. Otherwise, remainder is always less than the divisor. So here is the problem. Now, remainder is more than the divisor. So, for the solution of this, we will divide 14 by 9. 9-1, you will get 5 here. So, we will add this quotient 1 here. 358, and 5 will be the remainder. Okay? So, quotient 358 and remainder is 5. You can check by traditional method. 3227 divided by 9. 9327. 12 minus 7, 5, 2. 95, 45. 12 minus 5, 7, 7. 9872. Now you can see quotient is 358 and remainder is 5. Okay, now let's take one more example. 1,23,464. Now divide this large number by 9 by using this trick, and you know very well. First step, write first digit as it is. Now add next digit to this 1, 3, 3 to next digit, 6. Now 6 plus 4, 10. Now we can't write 10 here because it is a 2 digit number. So we will write 0 here and 1 carry. Okay. Now add 10 to the next digit, 6, 16, same. You will get 16. We will write 16, 6 here and 1 will be here. And now 16 plus 4, 20, and put the stock here. Now 20 cannot be the remainder because it is greater than the divisor. So divide 20 by 9, you will get 2 as quotient and 2 as remainder. So we will add this quotient to here. Okay, and 2 will be your remainder. Now add this 6 and 2, 8, 1, 6 and 1, 7, 3, this. And remainder is 2. So quotient is 13,718 and remainder is 2. Clear? Now I am taking one more example. 92,401. Okay? Now divide it by 9. First step, you know very well. As it is. And 9 and 2, 11. Now we can't write 11 here. So 1 will come here. Okay? Now 11 plus 4, 15. We will write 15. 5 here and 1 will come here. Now again 15 plus 0, 15. So 5 will come here, 1 will here. Then 15 plus 1, 16. And now divide 16 by 9. 9. 16 minus 9, 7. So 7 will be your remainder. And add this quotient here. 1. Now add this. 5 plus 1, 6. 5 plus 1, 6. 1 plus 1, 2. And 9 plus 1, 10. So 10,266 is your quotient and 7 is your remainder.